life-changing Islamic lectures. My Sheikh Imam Javed Khatami.
وأصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اتبع بهديه واقتدى بسنته إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يسألونك عن الخمر والميسر، قل فيهما إثم كبير ومنافع للناس وإثمهما أكبر من نفعهما. صدق الله المولانا العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Our topic tonight, inshallah for the next 4 weeks, we'll be concentrating in regards to some of the major sins or the kabair sins we are mentioning in the Quran. So tonight is the first part of the topic of Islam and alcohol. Islam and alcohol. So tonight is the first part. Inshallah, next week will be the second part. And also we'll talk next week in regards to the laws and the hukams in regards to alcohol, i.e. in terms of business or in terms of doing trading or keeping it at home, whatever basically, or somebody working for that kind of company, industrial. Inshallah, Sheikh Mahmoud bin Saeed will deliver that next week, inshallah ta'ala. Before we go any further, I just want to emphasize a few things. Our creator is Allah. Our sustainer is Allah. Our cherisher is Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through His sheer power, He created me, you, and the billions and millions of humans walking on the surface of this earth. And it's a human nature when the human himself or herself does something good or makes something, then appreciation of that goes to the highest level. For example, our mothers and sisters at home, they cook dinner for us. They spend 2 hours, 3 hours. They look after our children. They look after the household. And they prepare dinner or lunch for us. And it's a human nature that when they prepare food for us, for husband or brothers or parents or whatever, they'll make sure that this food that they have prepared with their own hands is to the best level in terms of taste. It's to the best level in terms of taste. And also, not only that, they would like the appreciation that somebody will say, "Mashallah, fantastic. Mashallah, very beautiful food. Mashallah, very tasty." You know, it's an appreciation. You know, there was one, an imam like me probably, giving a khutbah, halaqa one day. And the imam was saying that what's happened to us, that we don't appreciate our wife's cooking. We should at least say something good, something nice when they cook. And he gave a lecture, halaqa. So probably there was one brother there listening very carefully to it, and he got home. And as he reached home, dinner or lunch was ready. So mashallah, he started eating, and mashallah, eating, and the wife was just next, sat to him, and he started saying, "Mashallah, what a beautiful food today. Very tasty, mashallah." So he, after every morsel, every lukma, he's just saying, "Mashallah, mashallah, fantastic, alhamdulillah." And the wife sat next to him. She's going red, pink, grey, all the colours that you can imagine. After he finished and he started licking his fingers, "Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, what a beautiful food today I tasted." The wife says, you idiot, I've been cooking for you for 21 years, you never praised me. Today, the next door neighbor wife cooked and you started praising her so much. So there is a time to praise also. So they like this kind of praising. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created me and you, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows also what is good for me, what is good for us, what is harm, and what is beneficial. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. There will be no way that Allah is going to create me and you and say, do whatever you want to do, kill yourself, whatever. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like this kind of attitude. When Allah has created me and you, He had kept benefits, and He had kept goodness, and He had kept good things for me and you as far we do something good. So the Quran, which is from beginning until the end, when Allah talks about fornication or pornography or adultery or zina, why does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala detest that? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings an aib to zina, fornication? Many reasons. But one of the main reasons that we are facing in today's time is the illness of AIDS, which is, according to medical research, once a person has got this HIV or whatever virus, there's no treatment to that. So Allah, that's one of the reasons. Another reason is, Islam is pure, Allah is pure Himself, then obviously if everybody starts doing zina and adultery, then how can a person will be able to identify if it's my child or someone else's child? Because nasl, progeny, family plays a big part in a system, Islamic system. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows what was good for us, what is wrong for us. He, through sheer hikmah, which we read the attributes, the qualities, the sifat of Allah, there are 99 sifat. Amongst those are Al-Hakim and Al-Hakim. Allah is the all-wise, Al-Hakim, all-wise, and Al-Hakim is the judge. So He knows what is good for me and you. Now unfortunately, sadly, in tonight's topic, which I'm going to talk about Islam and alcohol, that some of us, say, na'udhu billah, may Allah forgive, that, okay, alcohol has been made haram. But there are benefits to it also. If benefits will be more beneficial, or if there were more benefits in alcohol or consuming alcohol, then I am 101% sure, not 100%, 101% sure that at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when the Jahiliyyah, the time of ignorance and Jahiliyyah, in which alcohol consumed was an everyday, in every party, in every house, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have never revealed 3 different verses in regards to the detest or in regards to the bad habit of alcohol. If alcohol would be beneficial for me and you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what is good for us and what is bad for us. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about good for us, He mentions in the Quran what is good for us. He mentions in the Quran, reading of the Quran is good for you. He mentions in the Quran to perform 5 times daily salah is good for you. He mentions in the Quran to give charity, give zakat is good for you. He mentions the hajj is good for you. He mentions not to lie is good for you. He mentions to lower your gaze is good for you. He mentions to control your tongue is good for you. So all these, all the aspects of life, when Allah has said, do this, you will get benefit. Surely, we know that if there would be benefit in consuming of alcohol, then Allah would have said, Muhammad, don't say it is haram, let them consume because there is benefit. Let them have it, there's benefit in them. And unfortunately, because of our lack of knowledge, and lack of understanding the Arabic, we think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in the Quran, the ayat kareema that I've recited, يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْخَمْرِ وَالْمَيْسِرِ Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are asking you in regards to wine, when my said on gambling, I won't go into gambling because that's another topic from Molana Yunus, inshallah, we will deliver in a few weeks. My topic's about alcohol, so they asked me about alcohol. قُلْ فِيهِمَا إِثْمٌ كَبِيرٌ قُلْ فِيهِمَا إِثْمٌ كَبِيرٌ The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was told by revelation of wahi that Ya Rasulullah, قُلْ Say to them, قُلْ فِيهِمَا In both of them, إِثْمٌ كَبِيرٌ Now it says if Allah would have not brought the word kabir, not kabir by which is sitting over there, obviously, the word kabir, which means severe, very high, it says just by bringing the word ithm, which means sin or a bad action, then itself a person will understand that this is a bad action. But by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bringing a sifat, a quality, which is kabir, which is mean it's a great sin. Not only a sin, but a great sin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that do not even go towards something it's a great sin. Now, na'udhu billah, astaghfirullah, some of us says, Imam, yas'alunaka anil kham. Anil kham means only wine. Only wine. No liquor, no the other kind of alcohol that are mentioned. The word khamr means actually intoxication. Means intoxication. If you look in the Arabic language, probably, it means intoxication. Something that intoxicates you, regardless if it is one sip or 100 sips, regardless of that. You know, a lot of us, a lot of brothers say, only one sip, I'm only taking one sip. I haven't got intoxicated. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about that. قُلْ فِيهِمَا إِثْمٌ كَبِيرٌ Now for us to understand all this, the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala majma'in, you know, I even heard from Muslims saying, it is not fair that the Sahaba previously were consuming alcohol and why can we not do it now? The Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala ajma'in, that when the Quran was revealed to them because they had the culture, the rituals of jahiliyyah and ignorance in a daily basis in their life. The cultures of jahiliyyah was like a running blood in the body. A person living in that lifestyle for 30 years, 40 years, 50 years, it's very difficult for that person to come out from it. That's why, what did they do nowadays? The NHS put all this initiative that to give up smoking. And when they do the counseling or when they do the surgeries in giving up smoking, they don't say to you just give up smoking. They say, okay, cut it down, then they'll give you the patch, or they give you the nicotine, or they give you some kind of, which is in kind, you can stay away from the actual tobacco and go into something else. Nowadays they have the electric one, basically. They said it's not harmful, but I think still it's not harmful. Regardless, not go into that topic. But I want time to say to you, when a person is in a bad habit, to take them away directly from that bad habit, it's very difficult. It needs a lot of effort to be taking a person away from that bad habit. That's why the Quran, when it was revealed bit by bit. Bit by bit. The Quran was not revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in one whole go. Because if the Quran would have revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in one whole go, it would be difficult for the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala ajma'in to practice upon the whole Quran. That's why what they say. What did they say? Nahnu, where we learn the Iman first and then we learn the Quran. We learn Iman first and then we learn the Quran. Which is mean as how the Quranic verse was revealed, they will practice upon it. They will practice upon it. So at the time of the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala ajma'in, when they were in Mecca, the consuming of alcohol was to the highest level. When in Madinatul Munawwara, when they migrated to Madinatul Munawwara, unfortunately some incident happened in which some of the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala ajma'in got involved into a heat up conversation with another tribe of the Sahaba, and they started insulting each other as the way they used to do in a time of jahiliyyah by reciting poetry in terms of insulting the other tribe against the other tribe. So amongst the very eminent Sahaba, people mentioned Mu'adh ibn Jabal was one of them, Abdullah ibn Abbas was one of them, and but the main one which is mentioned in the tafsir, is Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala an. Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala an came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulallah, you know, we have to put a hole or stop into this alcohol business because Alhamdulillah, we have accepted Iman and Islam, but unfortunately, we still got the tradition and the cultures and the rusumat of Jahiliyyah, ignorance. And with that, what's happening is that a lot of the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala jama'in still have this tradition of the Jahiliyyah, and they're still insulting each other. So Umar radiallahu ta'ala made a dua to the Prophet sallallahu, not to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, Ya Allahumma bayyin lana bayanan shafi'a. Allahumma bayyin lana bayanan shafi'a. O Allah, send upon us a clear identification or a clear hukam or ruling in regards to alcohol. He made this dua. When he made this dua, the first verse was revealed, يَسْفَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْخَمْرِ وَالْمَيْسِرِ قُلْ بِهِمَا إِثْمٌ كَبِيرٌ وَمَنَافِعُ عَنِ النَّاسِ, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it's a great sin, stay away from it. But still the hurmat or the illegal of making alcohol was not given by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One day in Madinatul Munawwara, there was a big party. Amongst the eminent Sahaba in that big party was Abdurrahman ibn Auf radiallahu ta'ala. Abdurrahman ibn Auf radiallahu ta'ala was also in this big party. What happened was that it was the time for Salat al-Maghrib, and because of the consuming of alcohol makes a person intoxicate, and sometimes this person loses the sense of what this person is saying or what this person is trying to say. At the time of Maghrib Salah, when they read Salah in a specific place known as Masjid al-Nabawi, the person leading the Salah read قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ, instead of لَا أَعْبُدُ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ, he read أَعْبُدُ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ. So لَا أَعْبُدُ means we don't worship what you worship. But this person said, أَعْبُدُ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ, we worship what you worship. So realistically, in fiqh, if we look at this, the Salah is fasq and batin. The Salah is nullified because the translation has changed. When the translation changes in Salah, the Salah becomes nullified, void. So this became very famous in Madinatul Munawwara, that this person recited the Quran like this. So they came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Rasulullah, we read Salah, and this person was intoxicated to alcohol, and this is what he read, what should we do? So Umar radiallahu ta'ala was there also. He looked at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that is there any wahi or any hukam or any command? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed another verse. Ya ayyuhal ladina amanu la taqrabu salata wa antum sukara hatta ta'lamu ma taqulun. O people of Iman, la taqrabu salata, do not approach salah, do not perform salah whilst you have consumed alcohol and you are intoxicated. So which means that the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu ajma'in started taking more precautions in terms of consuming alcohol, because we know we pray 5 times daily salah, and when a person consumes alcohol, the nasha or the intoxication that could last for hours, not only for 1-2 minutes, a person could be intoxicated for hours, you know, until this person loses all the sense. So the Sahaba radiallahu ajma'in started having more precautions in terms of consuming alcohol. Hence alcohol became much more lesser then, but still some of the Sahaba will consume it at night when the Isha Salah will have been prayed, because from Isha to Fajr there will be a huge amount of time that a person could recover and obviously could go to sleep. Still, unfortunately, there was some kind of, some insult carried out amongst the Sahaba radiallahu ajma'in, and they will still make mockery at night when consuming alcohol. So Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala made the dua again, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala finally revealed the third verse, which is in Surah Al-Ma'idah again. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran that إنما الخمر والميسر والأنصاب والأزلام رجس من عمل الشيطان. رجس من عمل الشيطان. Now we have to think carefully what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to say. He says رجس. رجس. رجس means in our language ناباكي. Filth. Dirt. Filth. Dirt. And we know how much filth and dirt come from our body when we go for the call of nature. Now, if anybody in a position to touch that filth or dirt when we go to the call of nature, any one of us would like to touch it? No. No, we don't. And even if we do, so much soap, so much washing of liquid in our hand, so our hand does not smell. So none of us will be so happy to touch it and to walk around with it. So rich means filth, dirt, and you detest, you don't like it. So similarly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, rich sum is a dirt, is a filth, but not only that, but it's one of the action of shaitan, min amali shaitan. Subhanallah, this is the main part. It's one of the actions of shaitan. And we all know shaitan is our enemy number one. Enemy number one. Shaitan is our enemy number one. He does not want us to be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَأَغْوِيَنَّكَ أَجْمَعِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran that shaitan has made qasam to Allah. قَالَ فَالْحَقُّ وَالْحَقَّ قُولُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that, yeah, no problem, you make promise. You make promise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, no problem, your promise will be fulfilled. إِلَّا مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُخْلَصِينَ. See, only those, my highest servant will be saved from you who will worship me. So Allah does not only say rich, but He says, مِنْ عَمَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ. That alcohol is also amongst the action of shaitan. Action of shaitan. Now, action of shaitan, which means shaitan does that, or shaitan make us do that, so for us to go astray and away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that if you do, na'udhu billah, may Allah forgive us, consume alcohol or wine or whatever intoxication, then know that you just have carried out one of the actions of shaitan. And the person who have carried out one of the actions of shaitan, he is the brother of shaitan. He is the brother of shaitan. And if we become the brother of shaitan, that means there is no iman and Islam in our heart. There is no iman and Islam in our heart. And then the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, no mu'min can be a mu'min when that person is fornicating or committing adultery or zina, or drinking alcohol and wine, which means that iman flees away from his heart. Iman goes away from that person's heart. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala finally revealed this ayah. When this ayah was revealed, it is said, subhanallah, in the books of tafsir, subhanallah, it's very beautiful, that Medina became like a river flowing of alcohol. Not that everybody was swimming in there, but the Sahaba radiallahu ajma'in had this quality which we have mentioned over and over and again, of a quality, of a beautiful quality of سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. We have heard and we have obeyed. So they obey the commandment of Allah, they obey the wahi and the revelation. Hence, whatever they had alcohol stored in any place they have alcohol stored in, they said they emptied it out. And Medina was full like a river flowing of alcohol until alcohol disappeared from every single house in Medina. From the Muslimin house, obviously. So the Sahaba radiallahu ajma'in gave up that. Now my question is over here. If alcohol would have been still permissible, then I am sure at least there would have been at least one hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, at least one hadith, or at least one practice of a Sahaba, at least one practice of the Sahaba, if not a hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, by saying that, okay, of alcohol, at least one Sahaba would have mentioned it in terms of his own practice that I heard from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam or whatever. But there is nothing like that in the book of hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has mentioned a hadith in terms of the benefits of alcohol, regardless if it's one sip or not even a Sahaba's action or Sahaba's amal has come to make us an evidence of that, that alcohol was still permissible. It is one bit of it. So we come to know unanimously that alcohol became haram at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but the Sahaba radiallahu ajma'in were there. And if alcohol was still permissible was still permissible, then at least we would have known from the action the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala ajma'in somehow, somewhere narrated that the Sahaba still consumed alcohol. But there is no of that in any book of hadith, in any book of hadith, or in any book of any Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala ajma'in, that they still consume alcohol after the Dimash of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And obviously, the thing is that, unfortunately, I will just mention it, is the action of shaitan, rijsun min amal shaitan, it's the action of shaitan. And shaitan knows that when a person consumes alcohol, he will go from the highest level to the lowest level. To the lowest level. 1 minute he's, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ The other minute is, ثُمَّ رَدَدْنَاهُ أَسْفَلَ سَافِلٍ. You know, 1 minute he's the best creation of Allah, then the other minute he's the lowest creation of Allah. Because shaitan knows that when a person is intoxicated, he can do so, he can commit so many other actions that could make, could be a consequence for that person. For example, a person which is intoxicated, he doesn't know what's happening, he could just commit a crime, for example, raping someone. And raping someone, if the authorities get to know, you're behind the bars. And when a person is behind the bar and in prison, he loses all the dignity and respect. And shaitan wants that, wants that. And if that doesn't occur, then he could be involved into a fight. And that fight from small could go bigger and bigger. He could stab someone or could kill someone. That could happen also. Not only that, na'udhu billah, may Allah forgive, even though some ulama, some a'imma have said that divorce of talaq does not take place while you in intoxication, but he might say to his wife, I've divorced you without knowing it. But still, these all are consequences in which a person consuming alcohol could have and could play a very big impact and bad action, not only in his life, in his family, in the community, everywhere basically. So shaitan knows this and shaitan plays a trick. So little alcohol or one whole pint, regardless if you do. I say the same thing. If you steal one bar of chocolate from Tesco and you've been caught in the CCTV camera, or you steal one big TV of 32 inch and you've been caught, still you will steal it. Still you will steal it. Regardless if it's one bar or one big TV. One seed or one pint still is alcohol, which is the Quran says it is not permissible at all. Now subhanAllah, there is a very famous doctor, Dr. Robertson in America. He's written a lot of books and alhamdulillah, mashallah, he's written a lot of good things about Islam and how Islam prevent people from doing the bad action, i.e. alcohol and consuming and drugs. And at the end, he has written in there that if the community, or if our people, or the human, will stop two things, the consuming of alcohol and being drug addicts, then half of the prisons will be empty and half of the hospitals will be empty. Half of the prisons will be empty and half of the prisons of the hospital will be empty. That's what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has mentioned in the hadith, that alcohol is, with the nearest meaning, Ummul Khaba'ith. Ummul Khaba'ith is one of, is the mother of all the evil. Now the question arises over here, mother of all the evil, mother. Why not father? Why not mother? Why mother? Ummul? Why not Abul? Why mother? Because either the mother have got so much love, affection for the child, number one. Or secondly, may Allah make it not happen, but secondly, when there is a female who na'udhu billah, does a bad action and she conceived, and through that bad action a child is being born, then we are still in doubt who is the father. But of being the mother, we know she's the mother. There is no doubt whatsoever. There is no doubt whatsoever. So the mother has got either goodness or badness. So Ummul means either it will be goodness or badness. But when the Prophet ﷺ mentioned Khaba'is, is the evil, which means that will take you to the bad action. It won't take you towards good action, it will take you to bad action. And people nowadays say that, oh, the doctor says if you, there is no such a thing. If the doctor say if you consume or if you take alcohol, you will be cured from all the illness or any illness. It's not, nothing like that. There is no such a thing like that. I've asked you doctors before coming to give this lecture, so we don't prescribe anything like that. Alcohol is alcohol. Regardless of who that person is, if that person is a Muslim or non-Muslim, still this person will face the consequences and will face so many other bad actions in terms of that. There are so many harms, which I did some research asking to doctors basically and myself, and you can just go on about those harms of alcohol. One of them, it says that through alcohol, the stomach gradually loses its ability to function properly. The stomach loses the ability to function properly. Causes loss of appetite. Makes one's age quicker, go much older. The progeny of alcohol are weaker. So if you get a child or anyone like that, they become very weaker. Causes heart failure. Consuming of alcohol causes heart failure. Creates fights and enmity between people, obviously, that's what we just expect. And the main thing is thousands of pounds are wasted in this. Thousands of pounds are wasted. Thousands. And we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in the Quran that when you spend, wala tusrifu, do not spend with israf, exaggerating, extravagance. Spend what you need. Because innal mubadiriya kanu ikhwan ash-shayatin. That the person who did israf and exaggerated spending, they are the brothers of shaitan. They are the brothers of shaitan. So we are either spending in haram and we are consuming haram also. So this is just a brief background in terms of alcohol and what the Quran and the Hadith says about alcohol and intoxication. Inshallah, next week, the whole rules and regulations and the hukam and command in regards to more about alcohol will be delivered by Sheikh Mahmoud bin Saeed, inshallah ta'ala. In here we finish with this, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala safeguard us and our generation from alcohol and from this evil drink that is, na'udhu billah, and may Allah forgive, is destroying families, is destroying brotherhood, and it is destroying houses also. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us right understanding, inshallah ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala safeguard us and safeguard our iman also. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us few amongst those who will stay away from this evil drink and evil actions, inshallah ta'ala. Wa akhir da'am, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, wa sallallahu ta'ala ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala sahbihi wa sallam. Rahmatika ya arhamar rahim. Jazakumullah.